Mother, mother, there's too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way to bring some love in here today. Oh, picket lines and picket signs. Don't punish me with brutality. Talk to me so you can see. Oh, what's going on? What's going on? Yeah, what's going on? Oh, what's going on? Right on. Mother, mother, everybody thinks we're wrong. Oh, but who are they to judge us? Simply cause our hair is long. Oh, you know we've got to find a way. Bring some understanding here today. Oh, oh, oh. Picket lines and picket signs. Don't punish me with brutality. Come on, talk to me so you can see why. What's going on? Yeah, what's going on? Tell me what's going on. I'll tell you what's going on. Ooh. Right on, right on, babe. Right on, right on. Right on, babe. Right on. Right on, babe. Come on. Right, right on. Right, right on. Right on. No sweat.
I see the rain pouring down before my very eyes. Should come as no surprise. I see the rain pouring down before my very eyes. Should come as no surprise. I'm searching and praying and hoping for something. I know I'm gonna see it. I know that it's coming, Lord. Huh. Lord. Huh. But what do you do when there's no place to turn? I have no one. I'm lonely. My bridges have burnt down, Lord. Lord. Bells getting loud, ain't nowhere to hide, got nowhere to go. Put away my pride, tired of feeling low. Even when I'm high, ain't no way to live. Do I wanna die? I don't know. Bells getting loud, ain't nowhere to hide, got nowhere to go. Put away my pride, tired of feeling low. running low, even when I'm high. Ain't no way to live. Do I wanna die? I don't know. I don't know. Bells getting louder, louder. I see the rain pouring down.
We got the fight. evening, everyone. I'm Annika Rose, an intern at Kenny Leon's True Colors Theater Company. And on behalf of Artistic Director Jameel Jude and Director of Education Nikki Toombs, we'd like to welcome you to the virtual presentation, Frame of Mind, written by the Fall 2020 Digital Playmaking class. True Colors Education Department prides itself at being one of the leading arts education programs throughout the nation. From our annual August Wilson monologue competition to our mentoring and literacy programs, Act Like a Lady and Page to the Stage, we thrive at the intersection of artistic excellence and civic engagement. This year's internship class had a firsthand, authentic look into the world of regional theater, as True Colors and organizations all over the world had to pivot and live up to the adage, the show must go on. And we, as an intern class, were front row and center as we partnered with the TCTC staff seeking to be intentional about the stories we tell and the lives it impacts. True Colors can't do what they do without the generous support of our donors and sponsors. We'd like to take the time to thank the Zeiss Foundation and the Divinely Connected Productions. We would also like to shout out the participating universities for our internship class: Clayton State University, Emory University, Howard University, and the University of Oklahoma. Feel free to shout out your school in the chat. This presentation is about 45 minutes with a 10-minute talkback after the performance. So stick around and tell us what you think and be a part of our discussion. And without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Frame of Mind.
The world's idea of frame of mind is to influence one's behavior. Whether that makes them cruel or kind is only in that one's favor. This meaning will forever stay the same, maybe up until the end of time. But today, we're going to change the game, all because of a tragic crime. Our idea of frame of mind is to go back in retrospective, to look through the eyes of nine and gain their perspective of the killings that befall the ones who try to fight, not to scare others, but to fight for what's right. Ahmaud, Taylor, Brooks, and Floyd. Too many lives lost. It's created a void. We can't just sit here and continue to rest. So you sit back and enjoy, because this story begins with a protest.
Southern trees bear strange fruit.
Thanks, Tom. Today I'm here in the midst of another peaceful protest for the city of Atlanta being led by the people who want answers after another tragic shooting. 15-year-old Tyrell Jackson was shot and killed by an unknown assailant on the evening of November 10th while walking home. According to Jackson's sister, who's been actively at the front lines of this protest, and who also claims to have witnessed the incident, an officer was responsible for shooting her brother that night. At this time, there has been no reports of this to the local authorities. The Atlanta police chief has claimed that all of the department's officers were accounted for. To get a better insight on the story, Nicole Jackson has offered to share more details of what happened that night in hopes of getting justice. Ms. Jackson, what else can you tell us about what happened that night? And about the unknown assailant.
He wasn't an unknown assailant. He was an officer of the law. I know it, and the chief knows it too.
That is a serious accusation. Is there any way to prove your story?
Me, I'm the proof. I saw his face that night, and the chief knows it. That's why he's hiding him from me. I am not even allowed in the police station anymore. They told me if I step foot in there again, I'll be arrested on sight. I don't care what it takes. I will get justice for my brother.
Why don't you start from the beginning? Tell us exactly what happened that night.
My brother and I were simply walking back home from the store. We ran into one of my friends there, so she decided to stay and chill with us. We weren't bothering nobody. We did this routine every day. How would we know that night would be the last night we will walk home together? We were messing around with each other like brothers and sisters do, and my friend was yelling at us to stop being stupid. He was getting on my nerves as usual, you know, normal stuff. We weren't too far away from the store yet, so we heard a lot of commotion, and then we heard someone yelling at us. I remember the words, "Stop, police, you're under arrest." We were really scared. I turned around, but I didn't see anyone in a police uniform. All I saw was some guy with a gun yelling at us and running towards us. It was probably stupid for us to run, but what did he expect us to do? This man is claiming to be an officer of the law, charging at us, aiming his gun at us. I turned to my brother and we ran. And the guy continued chasing us as if we were some criminals he was hunting down for the sake of the law. Or maybe for sport. If it was for sport, he definitely got tired of hunting, because next thing I know, bullets are flying at us and my brother is falling to the ground. He wasn't breathing. 9.
I'm sorry?
9. It took 9 bullets to take my brother down until this monster was satisfied. I couldn't move. I couldn't breathe. It's as if I was dying with him. And you know what this monster did? He ran. Ran! He shot Tyrell down like an animal. He ran. He couldn't even face his crimes. I had to take care of this myself. Tell my mother and look her in the eyes, saying that her son isn't coming home tonight, myself. My friend tried to help me, but it didn't feel right. I went to the police. I talked to the chief. I wanted answers. But what did they do? They ran just like he did. They accused me of lying and took my rage and changed it to me blaming the system with no evidence because of what's going on with the killings of our people and Black Lives Matter. I don't care what they think. Either way, the system has failed us. Failed my mother, failed me, and failed my brother. They're not taking the time to find his killer, but they have enough time to accuse me of fraud. But know this, I saw that man's face. I looked him in the eyes. I saw his hatred for us. No matter what it takes, I will make this right. I will fight for my brother. I will get justice.
Truly a tragic story. In a statement released by the family's attorney, it states, "We are devastated that there has been little progress in the investigation to find Tyrell's killer. We wish the police would set aside their pride and prioritize getting justice for our little boy." The hope is that the Jackson family and this community get the answers they are looking for. I'm Audrey Grant, Channel 5 Action News.
Why were you at the protest last night?
My business was looted.
What happened?
I got a notification last night and saw on my security footage of people breaking windows and rushing in. So, I went there to do something, save my shop. I live with my child and I run my store alone. I was scared, but my business is my livelihood and I couldn't just leave it like that.
What did you do when you arrived at the scene?
When I got to my store, I shouted at the looters from my car. You know, "This is my shop! Stop! Why are you doing this?"
They weren't listening, so I called my cousin and I waited. He cleared out the looters and I just stared at the mess. I didn't think the riots would be heavy in my area. They smashed in the windows, took my merchandise, took my cash. I felt violated. I was supposed to open next month because I couldn't afford to stay closed any longer. I put so much of my savings and my time and my work into the shop for my community, for my family, for myself, and it just... In minutes. Those looters are not right. I'm a black-owned business, too. I give to the community, too, you know. What's the point? Where does this leave us? And it's not just me, but my other black neighbors, my American black brothers and sisters' businesses. Where does this leave the community if you are hurting your own? I was not born here, but I have supported because I know the things this country, black people in this country have given me. But if they are going to protest, then just protest. And I cannot blame them. They are protesting against hatred, and I stand behind that. In Cameroon, there's similar violence. Violence against the people, by the government, by our leaders, by our police. Like, here on your news, you see people shot and killed in the street and their bodies left to rot. The people supposed to protect us and speak for us, treating us like animals, punishing us for small things they call resisting. Then, not expecting us to defend or protect ourselves because of it? No! I understand, but... But now I have to start over. I came to this country to have a better life and find a new community, and I already worked so hard to... Yes. Yes, I heard the shot. It was nearby. I heard it, but I was too distracted to see what it was or where it came from. There was so much happening, and I saw people running from something, but I was frozen. My cousin had to get me to my senses. I realized I was crying. He tried getting me to leave, and I was fighting him, thinking, how could I leave my store like this? Eventually, he got me outside, but that's when an officer took us.
Amale rachamim, shochen ban ramim, chamse menucha nochana, knafecha shichna, ba'amalot, kdoshim utchorim, katzochar, harakiyam rizvachim, et nishmat, what was his name? The man who died? I'd like to say his name and finish my prayer for his soul.
Where were you tonight?
I was outside the synagogue, watching the protesters go by. Some asked me to say prayers over themselves, loved ones, those who had passed. I said a lot for tonight. Do you know your Torah at all? The story of Moses? Well, my ancestors, the Israelites, were enslaved by the Pharaoh. God promised to free the Jews from Egypt, and he starts by instructing Moses to go to the Pharaoh and ask, "Let my people go. Let my people go." And the Pharaoh, every single time, refuses. Now, I don't want to turn this conversation we're having into a Seder, so I'll skip to the end. God eventually brings down the 10 plagues onto the Egyptians until the Pharaoh finally lets them go. Today, we have no Moses, no 10 plagues. All we have, all they have, is each other to shout, "Let my people go." What kind of Jew, what kind of person would I be if I hid inside?
What did you see?
People. Angry people. And how could they not be? A young woman had just come up to me, asking if we could sing the Shema together. She said it brought her peace. She had a look in her eyes that I couldn't quite place, and she was shaking, so I took her hands, and we closed our eyes, and we sang together. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. And when she opened her eyes, she still had the same look of fear and anger, but she had a soft smile on her face. And then she asked me if I was angry, and she pointed to some graffiti on the wall of the synagogue. I knew in that moment that the look in her eyes was a great conflict between what she believed was right and wrong. I told her I wasn't angry, because a little spray paint isn't permanent, but what she was fighting for very well could be. And then she thanked me and fell back into the sea of people chanting. And then the shock came. I opened the doors to the synagogue and beckoned people in, inviting them to find shelter in a place I knew God will be looking after them.
Did you see anyone suspicious?
I saw some men tonight who seemed to have a very similar ideology to a man from history who believed in the persecution of my people. They were the only hostile ones I saw, but I could not tell you if they had anything to do with this. All I know is those men were on your side tonight. Now may I finish my prayer? What was the man's name?
As long as he's
wanted. Good evening, everyone. I'm Captain Craig Turner with the Atlanta Police Department. And I came here today to provide an update on the events that transpired at tonight's protest, as well as address the state of our city. I'm saddened to report that what was initially a peaceful protest quickly escalated to the point of violence and mayhem. Our department has apprehended and detained several individuals who we have identified as having active involvement in this turn of events. Now, there have been a lot of theories and misconceptions about what happened tonight, and there are still several unanswered questions and things that we do not know. But what we do know, and what we've now been cleared to announce, is that our colleague, Officer Grant Johnson, was killed during a protest earlier tonight. He was shot in front of a local business on Peachtree. And after medics arrived, he was pronounced dead on the scene at 8:53 p.m. Now, we've launched a full investigation to identify those involved, because solving this crime is our top priority. Your safety is our top priority. See, because we take these cases very seriously, as we take all cases very seriously. You know, people often ask me how I want our city to be perceived by the rest of the country. And my answer is always the same: united. And we will see to it that we uphold this standard. Next, we would like to offer our sincerest condolences to the family of Officer Johnson. And I would like to take a moment to speak on his character. You see, Grant and I, we've been colleagues for the past 10 years. We attended academy together, and we worked closely ever since. And in those 10 years, I watched Grant grow into a loving father and husband. See, Grant, he became a family man, and he made it his mission in life to guide all our youth towards success. It wasn't just his own. Our kids go to school together. Layla and my daughter, Olivia, they had just started pre-K. And I remember she was so nervous about making friends. So Grant, he offered to pick the girls up from school in his squad car, you know, to give them some talking points at school. Whatever four-year-olds talk about, right? Made it feel special. And that's all she talked about for the rest of the week. Her cool Uncle Grant. But you know, that was Grant.
always trying to make things better for the kids, for the future of this city, because all he wanted was a better place for them. That's the kind of man he was. He was a good man, a good father, a good friend, and a good cop.
How is the department handling the calls for police reform?
Look, I understand that there's this idea that all cops are bad, but you have to understand that that's not fair. No one group of people is bad. I know that more than anybody. I didn't grow up in the best conditions. I saw the worst that my neighborhood had to offer. And I saw the way we were treated. Like we were second-class citizens. Like we didn't matter. I became a cop because I understand that pain. I know what this country can do. And if I can help these people before they have me called on them, then I will do it. And I will not hesitate. So you tell me, am I a bad cop? Oh, or was Grant a bad cop? Even though he volunteered with youth programs. Even though he treated my black daughter like she was one of his own. See, he never had the chance to tell the gunman that. See, they saw this badge and they saw a target. Listen, we were there as cops because we were assigned to be there. It's our job. Believe me, if things were different, we would have marched with you. So before you call for the defunding of our departments because of a few bad apples, think about the great people who do serve for the right reasons.
What do you have to say to the protesters?
I would say that your frustrations are heard, that they're understood. I understand you. He understood you. Why should his life matter any less more than yours? What, does my life matter less now that I'm in this uniform? Also, my desire to serve my community negates my black experiences. Is that it? Like, why should I have to call my life black or blue? Nothing gets better if we don't start bridging the gap, people. If it's always us against them and you against us, then things will never advance. Look, I'm a human, just like you. At the end of the day, none of this matters. If Grant were here now, that's what he would say to you. He would say that your life matters, that my life matters, that all life, that all this protesting only deepens the divide. So I, on behalf of this department, ask that you bear with us as we solve this case. And have a little faith in your justice system. Thank you.
As long as it's long.
I went to go find one yesterday, but I wasn't able to do it tomorrow.
That's great. So, I love it.
Yes, Governor, but do you support?
Ah, thank you for that question. You see, it's a tricky question, isn't it? Because you say you support one thing, and all of a sudden you're denouncing the other. Isn't this a bipartisan issue? Can't these things coexist? Can't we all just... I mean, of course, you know, African Americans have to deal with... Yes, I'm getting to that. BLM, right? I mean, obviously, I support that.
And the police department?
Yes, I support the police department. I don't think they are mutually exclusive. I'll say this. As your governor, I support the department. And I support those who don't support the department. Because I am listening. I am here for you. My thoughts and prayers go out to you who are frustrated, just as my thoughts and prayers go out to the family of Officer Johnson. And it is because of that, I ask you to hold off on all of this, for your sakes, for the sake of the department, for the sake of small businesses. Wait, because tonight, They are grieving too.
How long are you asking protesters to stay home?
How long? I don't have an answer for you.
But one could argue that it's been 400 years of oppression.
400 years? What does that... But that's a bigger problem, isn't it? One that you can't expect me to solve on my own, even in my position. In any case, it's one we can't solve tonight. Today, my friends, is a sad day, and I am disappointed. I am disappointed that the anger, the justified anger, yes, of these protests escalated to this deadly level. But I've seen these barricades. I've seen these highway takeovers, and I hear your anger. I understand the frustration and confusion these protesters must be feeling, because this battlefield should never have been a battlefield. There should never have been any casualties. But as we can now see, these casualties are on both sides. I don't think it's wrong to mourn the casualties of both sides. So I understand. But this, today, is not an issue of whether or not Black people matter, right? Because obviously they do. So yes, like I said, thank you for your question. What do you mean, didn't I answer? I just said it, didn't I? I thought I did. Well, yes, of course. You want me to say it? This seems... Yes, okay. Black lives matter. But...
Hey, breathe. No, don't worry about work right now. They haven't charged you with anything, and they aren't going to. Okay, like you said, you were literally on camera, nowhere near... Hey, you're gonna be okay. I wish I'd been there. I'd have hit the piece of shit who detained you. No, you're right, I shouldn't hit him. No, I should have taken that tear gas canister and thrown it right back at his stupid... caught face. Not that? Right, who would have burned me? We don't want that. Fine, then I should have recruited Jeff. He could take Helga handcuffs. I mean, no, I know it's not funny. It's just laughing so we don't, you know. We're gonna get you out of there, okay? But, yeah, hey, I assume they're listening to this, but there's something you should probably know. Just remember, everything is going to be fine. No, nothing happened. It's just, so they had a press conference this morning about what happened. The police chief, the governor, some representatives, you know, none of the organizers or community leaders, of course, but they started talking about the officer who died. Oh God, I thought you knew. Nah, he didn't make it. Yeah, it just, they're going on and on about his character, about what a good officer he was. And at the end they announced this citywide vigil for him. No, they didn't even mention. But then they put his picture up. It was him. He was the cop who killed Tyrell.
Well, 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 my brothers in blue. How are we doing this crazy day? There's crazy shit out there.
Where were you tonight?
I was out there with a couple of buddies of mine exercising our First Amendment rights. I mean, we got y'all's back. These rights, they're downright laughable. I mean, what are they even fighting for? Black lives matter? Yeah, buddy, all lives matter. Blue lives matter. You're not special. Please, I swear these people are ungrateful animals. They want some sort of special treatment? Hell, at this point, I'd say just go back. If you're going to raid our streets, ruin our neighborhoods, kill our men, we don't want you here no more. You know, maybe that's what we need, you know? A clean slate, a land just for our kind. You know what I'm saying? I mean, Jews got their own country, their own homeland. We should get one too. Land of the free, baby. It should be for those who appreciate the freedom we've been given, not for those whiny little liberals who want to all of a sudden change everything. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. I mean, what happened to the good old American dream? We got to get back to that mindset.
What did you see?
Hell, aside from all those snowflakes trashing our streets, hell, not much else. Some of them came up to me and my buddies and told us we had no right to be there. These idiots don't even know their own country's laws. One of them told me I shouldn't have a gun, that I was a threat. I asked him if he had ever heard of the Second Amendment. Now, I got a permit for it. I was just letting everybody know that I carry, you know, for self-defense, which is my God-given right as an American citizen. I mean, shoot, how many of you think were illegals? I bet you my life that most of them weren't even American. Sure didn't act like it. You know, I can trace my ancestry all the way back to the Mayflower. Yes, sir. I'm about as American as they come. And I tried to tell them that right after they said I was disgusting for waving my Confederate flag. Me. I was just standing there. They were the ones smashing windows and lighting shit on fire. Now, I have to admit, I lost my cool when one of them spit on my flag. I can take a lot of things, but disrespect for my family? No, sir. I won't let that slide. I didn't even touch them. I just got in their face and said that flag there is in honor of my Southern roots, my ancestors who worked hard and long to establish their home here like every other true American. My great-great-grandpa died in that war. I raised that flag to honor him and his life that he sacrificed for our country.
Did you see who fired the gun?
No, man. I didn't see anything. I mean, it's hard, you know. Their skin is so dark, so at night you can barely see anything. It could have been any one of them who killed that man. I mean, didn't they all look suspicious? I mean, you know how those people can be, gang violence and all that. It could have been anyone. Y'all gotta be careful out there. Protect your own. Don't trust a single one of them.
Why were you there?
I'd come with my friend Joy. She's really into all this kind of stuff, and she begged me to go. I tried to tell her they aren't really my thing, but she wouldn't let it go. Needless to say, with all this going on, I was right. I hated it. Like, all that and for what? What's changed? Nothing. I guess it was cool to see all the signs and hear all the chanting, but I don't think I'd go to another of those. Especially now that I'm in a police investigation because of it. I really had no idea what had happened until I was safe inside of some church. These people have gone crazy. You come to protest against police shootings and then shoot the police? I just don't get it.
What exactly did you see?
I was by the corner store when I heard the shot. I didn't know what it was, though. People have been trolling at these things lately, bringing fireworks to scare people. I figured it was that. I don't know. Everything was already getting kind of too intense for me, so I would have believed anything. But then look around, saw the crowd. Everything was crazy by this point. But I saw two groups yelling at each other. One was obviously BLM. They had the whole nine yards, the shirts, the signs, the chants. I can't remember what they were saying, but it sounded cool for sure. And the other group was holding up that American flag. You know, I don't know what it stands for, but it has the blue stripe. Everything BLM said, they countered with something else. But BLM had catchier phrases. Well, anyway, they were yelling at each other, getting in each other's faces, and Joy kept trying to go over there, but I didn't want to. Things already seemed tense, and I just came to look. I don't like to get involved in politics. I leave that to the officials. Well, she left without me, so at this point, I'm alone. And this dude on the other side of me just pulls out a can of spray paint and goes to town on the sidewalk. I mean, he was going crazy. I swear he used the whole can. Paint was flowing down the sidewalk. It was red, so it looks like blood. Go figure, right? The whole area smelled like sweat and spray paint and cheap poster boards. I hadn't seen anything like it before. So I watched him do that, and all of a sudden, pop. I look around and there are police surrounding those two crowds. But before I try to process it, Joy runs to me and pulls me out of there. She looked terrified, and I couldn't imagine why she'd let fireworks scare her like that. Then she told me.
What were you doing last night?
I was doing my job. Just like you should be doing, instead of wasting your time talking to me. I already told you I didn't see anything, so I don't know what else you want from me. I got a call telling me to cover the protest, another protest. You know how many of those I've covered in the last couple of months? Too many. Can you guess why they always call me in to cover these? I'm just trying to do my job. And look where that got me. You know what the sick part of it is? I think I had forgotten that those protesters are also fighting for me because I can't. No, I gotta stay neutral, gotta be unbiased. That's the number one rule in journalism. So if I wanna make it, I gotta keep answering those calls, getting down to the streets, interviewing people like Nicole, all the while pretending like I don't have a say. When was the last time you had to do something like that? Forget all your opinions and feelings and beliefs in order to do your job. Yeah. I bet they don't teach you that in the academy. It's funny. I learned how to control myself in journalism school. And they couldn't even give you one lesson between target practice and uniform fittings. I got down here tonight and left my mind back at home. That is what I gotta do now to get through these nights. I can't have my mind getting in the way of my career. I put in that earpiece and forget that I'm a woman, that I'm Black, that I'm a person. I just look at the camera, tighten up my grammar a little bit, and let the words come out of my mouth. They don't even feel like mine sometimes. But Nicole reminded me who I was, though. I saw myself in her eyes. I saw all our worst nightmares staring right at me. That pain. That's what we're afraid of. Not you or your trigger happy fingers, but the potential you have to take someone away from us. I bet you have her in here too, don't you? Don't you? I was with her up until the gunshot. She didn't do it. We both ran into the synagogue, but I didn't see her after that. That probably doesn't matter to you. I can see it in your eyes. Yeah. She's probably your prime suspect now, or some bullshit like that. I'm biased, my ass.
What happened at that protest?
I don't know. You tell me. I'm the one in cuffs.
Listen, this is no time for games. Someone was shot and killed at your riot.
See, this is what's wrong with you people. There was no riot. It was a peaceful protest until your boys in blue came and tried to take us down for no reason. I guess you saw me on the news, huh? Did I say too much?
One last time, Miss Jackson. What happened?
I don't know. It's like you're trying to push me into confessing for something I didn't do. Look, all I did was organize something to get the word out about what happened to my brother. Tyrell Jackson, you remember him? Yeah, didn't think so. I've been doing my part. You guys clearly haven't been doing yours. I did one interview and you guys come in guns blazing and tear gassing people as if you heard there was a bomber on the street. I wanted to stand with my people and make sure they were all right. But things kept getting worse. I could barely see where I was going. The reporter was still next to me from what I could tell. Then I heard that shot. It's still ringing in my ears. I knew there was no coming back from that. People were going to die, and I couldn't be one of them. I couldn't let y'all take me like y'all took my brother. I refused to let my mother lose another child. So the reporter and I ran until we could find a safe place to sit in until all this was done. Then we came across a synagogue where the rabbi let us in, opening his doors. There was a good amount of people from what I can tell. I can admit, I was scared. Scared for my family, the people outside, our allies. Hell, I was even scared for us, and for a little bit, I thought we were safe. But the people outside weren't enough for you, huh? You just had to add a few more people to your collection. You saw us run and thought, what? We were suspects? Do y'all ever just stop and think, hey, maybe we should chill out with all the violence? Always killing first and asking questions later. Anyways, you have the wrong one. It was probably one of your boys in blue who killed your victim. Did you think of that? Maybe your boys thought the victim deserved to go down the way he did. The way my brother did. You never found out who killed Tyrell, huh? Y'all still gonna pretend like y'all don't know who did it? You know, at this point, I'm not too worried about it. We both know that asshole got what he deserved. Look, I hope you find who did it, because life isn't something to play with. I've learned that the hard way. So once again, I don't know. I didn't do anything. The only thing that I am guilty of is not staying outside with the rest. My mother needs me. You won't take me. You won't.
Thank you.
happened last night was an American tragedy. Unfortunately, only the latest of many American tragedies. Officer Johnson may not have been a perfect person. None of us are. But he dedicated his life to the health and safety of our community. And he did not deserve what happened to him on the front lines, especially in a city he worked to serve and protect for years. Many of us are frustrated. Many of us are grieving. So I ask all of you, of every race and occupation, to take a moment to remember our common humanity. Extend your hearts and hands to each other in remembrance of this fallen American. To his memory, to his lost future, to his family. I have spoken to many of his colleagues. By every account, Officer Johnson was a fine officer who stood for equality, just like you, just like me. During his many years on the force, he served with dignity, bravery, and honor. And it is because of this, I would like to take this opportunity to award Officer Johnson posthumously with the Governor's Award for Excellence, the highest honor I can bestow. To life and to the law, to a good man and a better officer. God bless you, Officer Johnson, and God bless America.
What will it take for us to gain our peace, to gain our freedom, to get some release? We are tired of these chains, hate, and oppression. It's time to move forward. There's no room for regression. We are true to our words. We are not a threat. You can't kill me off as if my life's a bet. It takes one moment to be true and kind. In other words, it's all about the frame of mind.
We just wanna party.
Slipping up. Look what I'm whipping up. This is America. Don't catch you slipping up.